Welcome to the 200th episode of Dante's Comedy Tips.
This is where it all started for me. In 1986, when I was 15 years old, I drove up from San Diego to Los Angeles, and I came here with my comedy partner, Gerald Wolf, and some friends of mine from my high school, and we performed, and my MC that night was Jimmy Brogan, and he's never forgotten Dante and the Wolf. Anyway, it all started right here in 1986.
This is Dante and the Wolf comedy team. We were together from 86 to 88. We came out of Patrick Henry High School. So did this lady, Annette Benning and Faison Love, as well as Melissa Greenberg and Tommy Chung. The San Diego Comedy Store was my home, and in 1991, when I turned 21, I moved to Los Angeles. Soon after, I got on a show on BET called Comic View and even had my own sitcom. From there, I went on the road as a Comic View comic. Richard Pryor was my friend, and I even got to open for him. I then got into doing warm-up for TV shows and movies, and did it on tons of movies, including Spider-Man, Fat Albert, all of the Adam Sandler movies that had big crowds in them. Plus, I did Batman, and on and on and on. In 2003, my daughter Willow was born, and my life got better. In 2007, I became a cast member of NBC's Last Comic Standing. Look at all of the stars on one show. It was a really great experience. Right afterwards, I met my wife, comedian Rebecca Cochin, who hosted the AVN Awards soon after. She also is the star of all of the Eating Out movies, and if you're a fan of horror movies, oh my goodness, she stars in tons of them. She and I go out on the road together and perform all over the world at comedy clubs and for the U.S. troops. We were recently on a tour of the Middle East together and all over Europe and had the best time ever. They say that after Bob Hope, I have performed for the most U.S. troops. We had the honor of writing for Joan Rivers on the TV show Fashion Police on E!, and it was one of the greatest experiences of our life. We've been on lots of TV shows together, and then I started writing and directing commercials for the ShamWow guy. We came up with something called the Shticky. I even came up with the name for it, and lucky us, it made it on Jon Stewart. You know, shtick, like stand-up comedy shtick, you know. I wrote and starred in a movie with him as well. My wife and I started the company Golden Artists Entertainment. We have the Secret Comedy Club that will be all over the country soon. We also have been producing the U.S. Comedy Contest for the past 18 years. And I manage lots of celebrities and get bookings for lots of well-known people. My wife and I then wrote Bro, What Happened, which we also starred in and I directed. From there, we produced and I directed a movie called Unfallen. And that starred Michael Madsen, one of my favorites, and also another one of my favorites, James Hong. We then wrote the movie Euro Club, which I co-directed, starring Rel Battle. We're now back on the road and working with our company. We traveled together still, even though I'm a manager. And on the side, I am an activist. I spend a lot of my time filming the police and standing up for what's right. And coming soon, we have Killer Comics Unlimited, a new stand-up special starring a bunch of great comics that our company produced. A million other things happened within that time period, but this is just a little bit of history on me. Now let's start the show.
Congratulations on 200 shows!
Congratulations, man. 200 episodes? 200 episodes of tips?
Dante, congratulations on Dante's comedy tips.
Dante, Pat Mulligan here. I used to do stand-up at the Comedy Store in the 80s. You were probably just a wee lad then. Anyway, congratulations on your 200.
I wanted to congratulate Dante on 200 comedy tips.
Greetings, Dante, from frigid Kentucky. Just want to say congratulations on your 200th episode. This is an amazing accomplishment.
When I started doing this comedy thing 30 years ago, and I'm still doing it, I learned from you because you gave me some great advice and some great tips. So those of you that are young comics that are out there, listen to the man. He's been around the world. He's been on every television show. Take his advice.
Congratulations on your 200th comedy tip that's absolutely amazing. When I got into comedy, all I heard about how was about how cynical everyone was, how cutthroat everyone was, and it was so refreshing to meet someone like yourself that really looks at themselves as a mentor for the community and is looking to pass on their knowledge instead of hoarding it for themselves.
Dante, it's Mark Jaffe. Congratulations on Dante's Tips 200th milestone. That is awesome. Thank you so much for sharing your insight.
Hi, this is Eric Edwards. I'm a huge fan of Dante and his tips. I got to tell you something. All his tips are great, especially his self-promotion. He is one of the funniest, hardest working human beings I know. His tips are great. He's also one of the most generous people I know because all the tips that he give, some people charge a lot of money for, but he's, you know, putting them up there. So it's insane.
It's your pal Fern here, and I am here to say thank you and congratulations to my friend Dante, who has just posted his 200th comedy tip. There are few people in this industry who do as much as they do for the comedy community, and I'm talking about Dante and his wonderful wife, Rebecca.
Congratulations on 200 shows, and I'm married to you.
Hava, hava.
Hey, Dante, Joey Gaynor here. Congratulations on your 200th episode.
Dante, congratulations on 200 episodes, man. That's a really, really big, big landmark.
Dante, Kato Kalin here. Congrats on your 200th episode of Dante's Comedy Tips. I think what I learned is that you have props you shouldn't use in your... One second. Hello. Hey, I'm doing Dante's Comedy Tips. Oh, okay, thanks, Carrot Top. Call me back in a little bit, bye. Anyways, Dante, I think props are... I'm sorry. Hello? Hi, Carrot Top's mom. I'm talking to Dante. Dante, anyways, congratulations. What's going on? No, banana.
Let's take a look back at some of our favorite episodes.
I didn't know exactly what...
Just say... Thing. Wait, hold on.
They're going backwards.
Oh, man. All right, ready? Crazy. Hold on. Oh, click.
Hey guys,
yes.
And welcome to another Dante's Christmas Tree Comedy Tips with my beautiful wife, Rebecca Cochin.
Hello.
Dante's name on the wall tips. Dante's Schmoopy Schmack.
Dante with another Dante's giant microphone.
Dante with another Dante's weed comedy.
Dante with another Dante's Jedi comedy.
Dante with another Dante's green room comedy.
Welcome to another Dante's backyard funny butt stuff comedy joke tips.
Chateau tips.
Dante's in the car comedy tips.
Dante's heroes of comedy tips. Dante's New York comedy tips.
Comedy tips. Dante's comedy tips.
Dante's comedy tips. And they taste so good.
Hey everybody, Dante here with another episode of Dante's Comedy Butt Stuff. Today's tip is fuck your way to the middle. Oh, click.
Wait a minute. Wait, what?
Today we're going to talk about the importance of being on time.
My tips aren't just about the comedy side, they're also about the show business side. And here's one thing I can tell you right now, you better get your COVID shots because you're not going to be able to fly, you're not going to be able to perform that. You have to play to the whole room. How to do dialects and impressions. And I first want to start out by saying, you know how everyone can't sing? Not everyone has an ear for this. Knowing when it's time to move up and move on.
The definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over and expecting different results.
I'm gonna give you a comedy tip. A little tip from Flip. A Flip tip. Oh wait, that's a way better name than Dante comedy tip.
All right, so here's the thing. No. Right on the money.
All right, you guys, it's Dante with another comedy tip. And today we are with one of the funniest people on the planet, Mr. Jimmy Schubert, everybody. Oh, fuck.
There we go.
I'm getting the... Only that.
Thank you. We've got some technical difficulties we've got to fix.
And this is crooked. God damn. Everything's just...
Okay.
There we go.
All
edited.
Comedy tip of the day?
Comedy tip of the day.
Get the fuck out of the business. Go get something with benefits. The bottom's falling out of this bitch.
Him and his wife, Rebecca, are the best people in comedy.
Oh, thanks. That's how we feel about you.
One is people are... It's
one thing, I will defy what most comics say. Don't go out 7 nights a week and do comedy. Have one night a week at least where you're going out into the real world and experiencing life.
Keep the mic closed. There's so many comics that are coming through that have a great joke that you lose just because they don't know where to hold the damn mic, and you lose the thing that the joke's about.
When you're a newer comic, you shouldn't be afraid to ask for guest sets, but you shouldn't ask unless you can do the guest set.
Comedy tip of the day, if you wouldn't talk in the Hollywood Improv during a show, why would you do it in any other room in the country?
Soak it all in. If you're new, like, get up as much as you can.
Bring your own microphone. It doesn't have to be gold. But just bring your own microphone in these times of
COVID.
You have to upkeep yourself. Open your mind to learning. So many people are like, well, I already know everything. I don't need to learn anything. I'll tell you what. If some comic who had done this longer than me was putting out a bunch of comedy tips every day, I'd go watch them.
I want to talk to you about don't borrow or steal unless you ask. There are so many comics out there that think that we haven't watched old specials and that you can just get away with telling the jokes of some comic that you think isn't that famous, but everyone else already has it memorized, and you look like a fool when you come out there and you're reciting someone else's jokes.
Here's my advice. Whenever you play at a casino, don't make fun of gambling or the casino.
Oh my God!
Dante gets up. I'm trying to do it like that as well. I just want to say I love tip number 167. Don't be jealous or envious of other comedians.
On them all to be valuable in one way or another. You know, a lot of times as comedians, we feel like we're lone gunfighters walking town to town, and these tips kind of keep us centered and keep us focused on the end game. I just want to say, you know, for me, one of the best tips you ever gave was to remind people that you're a comedian. Just bring it up in conversation, even if it's with a waitress or just a random conversation. I probably had 7 corporate gigs that popped up that were well-paying, and I've got more coming. I wish you continued success, and I can't thank you enough for everything you do.
Make sure you get your cash up front, stuff like that. I mean, his tips are just great. I mean, I can't speak more highly of the guy.
One of my favorite Dante comedy tips was promote the show that you're booked on. There's nothing more frustrating than a comedian that thinks they're too good for that. Unless your name's Dave Chappelle, nobody's coming.
Side hustle. Get a side hustle. Be proud of it.
It's to be your 100% authentic self.
Half of being a good comedian is being a good hang. Nobody wants to hang out with an asshole, no matter how funny you are.
Oh, hi, Dante. It's me, Carson Kressley. I heard it's your anniversary because you're wonderful, you're gorgeous, you're Italian. And what rhymes with Italian? Oh, I know. Stallion, I heard. I heard it's impressive. Anyway, she's a lucky gal.
Hey, guys, it's Dante and my wife, Rebecca Cochin.
Hi, happy 200th episode, Schmoop.
It's Schmoopy's 200th episode, you guys.
Mazel tov.
All right, are you ready for your lesson? Here it is, 200. Number 200 is be kind, be good in comedy, be kind to the people that you work with, other comedians especially, the ones coming up. It's our jobs to give them free advice like these videos. I'm not making a dime off of these. It takes 2 hours a day to do it, just to post it and make them and edit and all this stuff. But it's worth it because you have to give back. I feel guilty for all my blessings, especially, I mean, look at her. I have to give back.
You know what I mean? This is my life. And there's, especially if you are like the headliner. When I go on the road, sometimes I'll get to the comedy condo and you can tell they have not put in new bedding for years, none of that stuff. So I'll go out, I'll go buy bedding for the place, leave, you know, pillows, right? We go out and we buy stuff for the place so that other comics can be more comfortable. We'll leave weed with a note for the next comics and
comics
even call them.
That.
Yeah.
If you can.
And even like when we were in Tri-Cities on New Year's Eve, there were comics that were working there and waitresses trying to get out of there at night. And we just stayed and helped them clean up all night because why wouldn't
we?
Well,
it didn't take all night, but it helped them. Yeah,
it like at midnight or 2 in the morning, they were, you know, we had time to help them get out of there early. Yeah. So we did it. And it's just things like that. If you're on the road and you can buy, you're the headliner, you can buy the feature lunch. Do it. Or the opener. Those guys need it. When we're on the road, we have stuff that we sell. But what do we say? We say buy our opener stuff first because we're getting paid more. And we are. Be kind. You guys, be kind. When you're kind, look at what you get. She's the best woman in the world, you guys. All right. It's my 200th episode. Oh, click. Oh, click. Oh, click.
Oh, click.
God, can't you do an oh, click real loud? Oh, click.
Oh, click. Oh,
that's,
click.
That's not what I want.
Oh,
no,
click.
No, it goes like this. We're outdoors. See people up there? I want them to hear. Oh, click.
Oh, click.
What? No, It's like, okay, okay. So yours is different from mine. I say, oh, click.
I have my way that I'm saying it.
But you have to yell it to them and say, oh, click. But it's a yes. Do you understand? Mine's a, do you understand? And then yours is a yes. Why is this so hard for everyone? Let's go through the oh, clicks. Oh, click. No click.
Click.
Oh, click.
No click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
That's oh, click.
Oh, click. You guys, listen to her, oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
And don't forget to click, okay? Click.
Oh, click. Oh, click.
Brag that you're performing, you dipshits. Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Yeah, no, oh, click.
Click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
And oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, click.
Oh, oh, click.
They take the time out of their day to post these tips to help comics become better comics, funnier comics, and better people. And it is greatly appreciated. So here's me saying thank you to them. Thank you guys for 200 comedy tips, and here's to 2,000 more. I love you guys.
Hey guys, so I did 200 episodes. I'm going to take a break. I don't know if I'm going to make more or if this is it, but I'm excited that I did 200. We'll see. I thought I was stopping at 100, but here I did 200. Anyway, be good to each other, and don't forget the number one rule of comedy, which is have fun on and off stage. We're the luckiest people in the world. Oh, click. Oh, click.